Hello everybody, Dr. Carlo Oger, board certified emergency physician with DrER.tv. Don't forget, visit that website. I'm working on it constantly. I'm going to make it super awesome with gallery of pictures, my latest post, and everything. All right, I'm going to do a double feature because I had one planned and then some questions came up about treatment of fever in kids. For those of you who are not used to seeing it, get used to it. So the dose of Tylenol orally in kids is 50 milligrams per kilo. Rectally, it's much higher. Some people say as much as 40 milligrams per kilo, but a good number would be 30, double the amount. So because the absorption of rectal Tylenol is much worse than oral, so you can give much higher doses. And in kids, they do so well anyway that even if with higher doses, it's not like it's going to cause a single dose, it's going to cause liver failure or any kind of overdosing or something like that. So, but the other thing that follows that is, what's the best way to bring a fever down? Obviously, medicating with Motrin and Tylenol. But most of your heat is lost through your head. And the best method of losing heat out of convection and what are all those methods? Evaporation. Evaporation is the best method. That's why the athletes dump the water. Now, water that falls in your body and drips down to the floor doesn't bring your temperature down too much. It's the water that evaporates from your system because there's more caloric transferred to that molecule of water that's turning into gas form. So in little kids or somebody you want to cool very quickly, you steam them. You actually spray them with water or you make them wet and you use warm water. You don't use cold water because cold water vasoconstricts the surface. So they get cold on the surface, but it actually creates like a layer of insulation to all the heat inside, cold and nothing comes out. So you want heat. It vasodilates, makes them almost warmer, but it helps the evaporation process and brings the temperature down. So the thing I do are like done in kids that have really high fevers, 104 and 105, that I want to cool, is to get their head nice and wet. Not moist with a little rag, wet, dripping, and with a little towel, and then let that evaporate. You tell the parents, give them a shower, let them play in the tub, and take them out. Don't dry them. Let the water evaporate. And that's the quickest way to bring a fever down. It's obviously medicating them and then doing that. But that was the one that came up today. I actually prepare a medical minute on something pretty interesting on how animals are amazing and how we discover things from them. We're going to talk about the Gila monster. And most people say Gila monster. I actually said Gila until I was doing the studies. So it's a venomous lizard that lives in southwestern U.S. in Arizona area kind of thing. It's about 2 feet long and about 5 pounds fully grown. And it has a venom that he actually injects through his teeth when he injects into the victim. People will get bitten by the Gila monster, said it feels like burning lava. And it can last up to 24 hours, the duration of that poisoning and pain. But what's interesting about them is they can go up to 6 months without eating. Usually they can eat large meals, up to 3 large meals for the whole year and be done. And they do hibernate because Arizona gets cold in the winter and they're cold-blooded animals. So they burrow in the underground, feed underground, and they shut down their system. They shut down all the secretions, shut down their pancreas and their kidneys. And it's actually the venom, the ingestion of the venom into the system that kicks back their system, which is pretty interesting. And that kind of led to research on that venom and why it does what it does. And they ended up finding that in order to do this effectively and jumpstart a system, they need to bring the blood sugar up and down and regulate and that kind of thing. So they discover a molecule called exedin-4. And this VA researcher, who is a physician, endocrinologist, and researcher, isolated this compound, found that this molecule stimulates the secretion of your body's own insulin. So it became a diabetes medicine we call Byetta. It's pretty cool, Byetta, because people who would normally have needed insulin injections, this Byetta medicine is once a day, it's a pill, stimulates your body's own insulin secretion. And as opposed to other diabetes medicines that sure control your diabetes but make you gain weight, diabetes actually helps with weight loss. So this amazing molecule that now become Byetta, discovered in the 1990s, came from the poison of a lizard. So that's kind of really cool. And that's it. That's the medical minute.
Tutorial.